Okay, welcome back to part two of this video tutorial. And you should have taken your background away, turned your image black and white, and then turned it to this rather fetching shade of blue. And it is now time to start doing the rest. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is go down to the bottom right-hand corner, click on New Layer, and it makes a new layer for you. Okay, you need to drag that layer by holding it underneath the layer that has your photo on it, okay, so that it's under there. You then go to the paint bucket, which is probably hidden, so you need to find it, okay, and then go down to the color drop and click on it and change the color to something a little bit more appropriate, like a dark blue. Click OK, go back to the paint bucket and click on your background and it should turn it into this lovely shade of blue. Click back onto the layer with your photo on it and it's now time to start doing some fun stuff. So go back to the layer tool, make a new layer, and they're going to keep this one above your photo because we're going to start drawing some lines. So you want to go to the paintbrush and underneath it you'll see the pencil tool. You need to make sure that the pencil tool isn't too thick. You can choose how thick you like it to be, but I would go roughly about that. Okay, and you want to go back to the color tool and choose a rather fetching shade of neon pink. Click OK, and this is where we start to have a bit of fun. Now, it's too far away at the moment, so I'm going to zoom in nice and close to my face. Okay, go back to the pencil tool. And this is where we can start drawing. Now, we use the shift key to help us here, okay? So you click, oh, see, I made a mistake there. So go undo, there we go. Click first, then press shift, and hold shift as you're drawing the rest. And you click a lot like you did with the polygonal lasso tool, and you click at different points. And as long as you're holding shift, it will let you click to different points, and then you go back to the top. I'm going to go up and around my eyebrow, back again, over the other side, and I'm stopping there as if it's going around my head. Okay, and this is where I don't press shift, I just click, and then I press shift again, click, click. And that's it. And then I can start drawing another part. And remember, the first time you just click with the mouse and then you press shift and you hold shift to do the rest. Okay. I didn't like that. So and that really is as easy as it is. The hardest bit really is deciding what you're going to draw. Obviously you want it to look as much like the artist's work as you can possibly get it, and you kind of want to think about the way your face is shaped so that your lines go around various features and around the eye and back down and then down the nose. So it really is as simple as that. Just remembering that clicking will just make the first dot, and then you need to hold shift to be able to then draw the other lines as straight lines. Okay. I'm just zooming out for you. Oops. There we go, zooming out. And starting from over here and kind of going round the ear a bit. Just to add something down the side. Thinking about my jawline and where I might use the lines along the shape of my jawline. scrolling up and then back to the side of my head. Okay, and then I expect you to just keep going until you are happy with the whole of your image and that you have enough lines. And that is the end of this part.